Well, tropical depression Amang maintains its strength even after making two landfalls. Let's get more details now from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Tropical depression Amang has already made two landfalls, first over Pangalibot, Catanduanes, 10 p.m. last night, and second in Presentacion, Camarines Sur, 1 a.m. today. Tropical depression Amang was last spotted over the coastal waters of Caramoan, Camarines Sur, maintaining its maximum winds of 45 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 55 kilometers per hour. Amang is now slowly moving northwestward. Tropical cyclone wind signal number 1 remains hoisted over Catanduanes, Sorsogon, Albay, Camarines Sur, Camarines Norte, Burias and Tikau Islands in Masbate, most of Quezon including Polillo Islands, eastern portion of Laguna, almost the entire province of Rizal, eastern Bulacan, eastern Nueva Ecija, and Aurora. Gusty conditions are experienced in these areas. Heavy rains will continue to batter Camarines provinces and Quezon today. The rest of Bicol and Calabarzon, most of Mimaropa, central Luzon, the eastern section of Cagayan Valley, as well as northern Samar, Capiz, Aklan, and Antique will also be rainy. Flooding and landslides in these areas remain a threat. Amang will continue to move northwestward in the coming hours and graze the northern portions of Camarines Sur and Quezon before weakening into a low-pressure area over central Luzon tomorrow afternoon. The weather disturbance will still bring rains over central and southern Luzon until Friday. Here in Metro Manila, rains this afternoon will start until the evening with short breaks in between. And that's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ariel Rojas there joining us live. Tropical depression Amang unleashed strong winds and intermittent rains in the province of Catanduanes. But local disaster management officials say the situation in the province has started to improve. They add the local government remains on alert for possible landslides. Signal number 1 is still raised over Catanduanes.
Lahat naman po ng area sa Catanduanes ay susceptible sa landslide. Although hindi na katulad nung panahon na talagang konting ulan na talagang naglalandslide. Sa ngayon po, medyo nagkaroon na ng stability. In 2 years na situation namin dito, nabawasan na po yung nasa monsoon season tayo, yung northeast monsoon, nabawasan na yung mga landslide.
And we have him back on the line, our correspondent Jonathan Maestrado, for the effects of tropical depression Amang in Camarines Sur. So, Jonathan, tell us about the situation there now. Has the weather improved? Floods subsided?
The weather here is still, we're still experiencing a moderate to heavy rainfall since this morning. And as I said, the police in Bumbon, Camarines Sur, ask the residents who live in flooded areas to evacuate voluntarily rather than to seek help in the afternoon or evening to avoid disaster. Mm-hmm. The official also asked the motorists and travelers to halt their journey at least until tomorrow and just stay at home to avoid accidents. Meanwhile, here in Naga City, Carmina, water level in the Naga River is still on yellow alert. However, several residents living in low-lying and flood-prone areas are still preparing and waiting for the signal from the local government unit in the event that they have to evacuate to safer grounds. Carmina.
Mm-hmm. Jonathan, let me just go back to that area where you mentioned that there was flooding because of an irrigation canal that overflowed. This area that you mentioned, is this the first time that they've experienced flooding? And is that irrigation canal a newly built one?
This area is one of the barangays in Bombon, classified as low-lying areas. Actually, the irrigation canal there has been rehabilitated, but due to the the volume of rain since yesterday, that causes the flooding in the area.
All right. Okay. So we talked about flooding. What about landslide prone areas? Are you guys keeping watch over any particular areas there, area there that's prone to landslides? Jonathan?
The eastern seaboard or the municipalities in the 4th district of Camarines Sur are the places or towns that are flood prone, particularly the Sangay, that municipality of Sangay, Caramoan, and the Presentacion, Camarines Sur. As of now, we don't have any details yet of such incidents, but I will get back to you when I get some details about it.
Sure. And as you do, please take care to you and the team accompanying you. Our very own Jonathan Magistrado there joining us on the line. Take care.